likelihood.
This is a long story. This is funny. You know that one of the members of the team is Chinese.
Oh.
And he got some kanji inspiration to make the island.
Yeah, it's easy to see in this plan. We use some old kanji for water to define the
island. Mizu. Mizu no kanji. But I complain a little bit about the shape, that it was not very attractive, and they simplified, but still we have to work a little bit more about that, because it's too free, and probably, but the idea I think is good, but the form is not that good. Probably we have to work on that. Yeah, true.
Then the site has a port in the light island.
Yeah.
In the Sambashi. And that space is for the sightseeing space.
Yeah.
And this is so attractive now. How do you deal with the space?
You mean this? This part at the moment now is a port area, isn't it?
Yeah.
And ships go in and out from this point, I think.
Yeah, we also modified the coastline. It is farther into the ocean, so we remove the harbor.
¿Dónde lo has llevado?
We moved the roads into the sides of the island. Through Inode and Shibaure. We added some more concept to a harbor, but we haven't solidified them. Mm.
Okay, they do not have the answer. They only know that they want to remove the port from there, but maybe they have to return to put a small port in the side, outside. Maybe it's an option. Yeah, it's a possibility. What do you think? It's okay.
Yeah, I think.
Any more comments? We can go to the following team.
Can you show us the last slide? The section?
Yeah.
Last slide. Yes. I think this is the essence of your proposal, and the right building. Stairs shape, and I think it seems that every room that is facing the railway, right? I think the opposite position is the
other. You got it?
Is facing to the ocean, not the railway.
No, what he's saying is that the Homa said it was Homa, isn't it? Who said that?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah,
he's saying that. Sorry, because the sound is not very good. I have to translate or say it again. He's saying that the section is the essence of your work. First thing, and the second, he's saying that this step building.
It looks like a stairs.
Yeah, it looks like a stairs building. He's saying that maybe should not make the steps towards the highway, but to the opposite direction.
All right.
Is his suggestion.
Yeah, I can see why.
But on the other side, maybe they can play in both sides if they improve the highway somehow. I don't know. Because at the moment, the highway is the frontier. And we need also to give some solution to the highway. If we think very rationally, probably we will not be able to do so, but because still they are urban design students, maybe they can try to do something in maybe in two directions. If not, probably the in front of the highway will be a definite wall. That's my worry also. But I agree with Homa was saying. Okay, very good point, I think. Okay, any more comments? Okay, we go to skip. Okay, here we are. Okay, now we are going with the third team of group two. Actually, you know one of the guys because it's Pedro. Pedro is coming now. With Oliver and Alejandro. Anyway, you know how to compartir, share, or okay. Okay, whatever. He's going to present.
Hi.
Himself.
Hi.
It's nice to meet you again.
So on my left, over here, you can see Oliver, and on my right is Alejandro. You first collaborate to make this analysis, okay? So I'm going to present. Just give me a second, let me show you this material.
My computer is going to explode. Can you cantar mal?
Can you see my presentation now?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. So I'm going to pass the first slides a bit fast. While you can see the pictures I'm showing, I'm going to explain a bit what do we do and why. So we find that the artificial island of Sibaru and Kinoden are two portions of reclaimed land that have been growing over the past 9 decades. However, they have not yet found an identity, a clear use, or a working urban structure. This portion of Tokyo Bay, belonging to Minato, enjoys great location with outstanding sights, a place to see and to be seen. If planned carefully, it could easily become the face of New Tokyo, a city that opens to the bay, remembering when Tokyo was the city of water. Let's remember that this project is made by three students who are not very familiar with Tokyo Bay. Therefore, we have to analyze the population, the economy, the environment, and also the landscape. Once we did all of that, we decided to center our study in five main points that would be mobility, urban grid, free spaces, architecture, and sustainability. Let's start with sustainability. We find out that in Tokyo, about almost 50% of the population uses the railway every day. Therefore, we really give a focal point to this area. We can find out that the Yurika of the line has two stops, one in the Hinode Island and the other one in Shibagafuto. Apart from that, Tokyo and Shinagawa stations are not far away, connected by the Yamanote line. On top of this, sorry, I'm a little bit faster. We find out also the transportation that Tokyo was having a problem with the oversaturated transport. Therefore, they came with a solution that it was what we call the upgrade, situating new major highways above the street level. While this principle was good, it has caused severe damage to certain areas of the city. The study islands of Shibaura and Henode has been scared with expressway number 1 and expressway number 11. We decide not to see this as a negative part, but a positive. These two highways across our area is giving us the chance to connect Shibaura and Hinode not only on a Tokyo scale, but also on a national and international scale if we decide that the expressway also connects the Haneda and the Narita Airport. After that, we start analyzing the urban grid. We decide to choose three of the main blocks in the area. one of them is in a longer version, then the other one has more rectangular and then a triangular area. Out of these three blocks, we decide to analyze how much is built, how much has of its pedestrian way, how much are open spaces, and how much is occupied by roads. Sorry, I'm going a bit fast, maybe. Out of this, what we discover is what the previous team say, that is lacking of green spaces. And maybe the pedestrian doesn't feel completely welcome, feels a bit out of scale. We also analyze the architecture of the area. And Tokyo Bay has the potential of being an emerging site. And other examples of great architecture that have become icons of the city, renamed architects as Kenzo Tange, Kengo Kuma, Sana, between many others, has already been working in Tokyo Bay. With all this information we already mentioned, plus some extra we're going to mention soon, we came with this synthesis of all our analysis. We have here the synthesis of the mobility, in which we decide that it should be good to create a cycle of life, as the previous team of Martha and Saskia mentioned. Having an older population mixed with younger families who are looking for quieter neighborhood, also connected with existing green areas like the Hamariki Park, and another area for the neighborhood more likely that will be related to the working population. A part of that, we want to change. At the moment in our analysis, we discovered that about 75% of the infrastructure is given to the hard mobility. We would like to change that and give 75% to soft mobility, at least, if no more. Which all said before, we came up with some numbers. We came out like in our area, according to the density of population in Minato area, we should host about 8,500 people. That divided by the 2.3, that is the average number of family members in the Tokyo area, will give us 3,650 houses and will take a space of 212,500 square meters. Apart from that, we should add to this a 26% of parks, 20% of education, sport facilities, playgrounds, social facilities, commercial facilities. Altogether, only on 36% of the 700,000 square meters we have, we could already host all of these 8,500 people, giving the remaining percentage to the city. With all in mind, we create this synthesis plan. You can see the residential areas. It's not just residential. The residential areas will include what we saw before. That will be parks, education, sports facilities, playgrounds, social facilities, and commercial facilities. Well, all of that will be summarized in the blue spaces. The blue area in Hinode Island will be a more quiet area, the one hosting all the population and families, young families who want also safe environments. While the blue area in Shibaura Island will be more for high and trendy areas for families, maybe that they are not so conventional. Maybe one member, maybe two members, new families who are also working and mixing all life. A part of that, we want to give some air to the highways, creating green areas around it. And the highway, we don't see it as an convenience, we see it as an asset for our proposal. And we think we can create an upper level, 24-hour city that is active and is always hosting the... Let's see how to explain it. It would be an asset for the city, not just for these two islands. In the two terabytes I can show now, it will include more or less the distribution of facilities that will be included in the left area of residential, the one belonging to Shibaura, and the right area, the one belonging to Kinode. We found out this is more or less the section type Shibaura at the moment. You can see how big roads are in three different levels. What we propose is to change this a little bit. What you are going to see now is a bit of a caricature of what we want, but I think you can show the idea. We want to make the highway into a continuous building that marked what is more into a city scale, while in orange is marked what is into a neighborhood scale. The neighborhood on the left, it would be the one maybe related to the trendy area, to the high, where it's more active, while the lower rise neighborhood on the right is more for older people and young families with kids, creating safe environment between real spaces. So we want to combine both city and neighborhood in the same islands. And I think that's all we have to say for now. So if you have any questions.
Okay. Did you change the proportion of use of land today?
Sorry.
You add residential area also. You change the population and the use of land.
So we took into consideration what's the use of land at the moment. And we found that this may be a bit too much industrial site at the moment. So
yes.
In this plant here, you can see what's marked on white, and there are buildings that we find that there are assets for our proposal. The rest, it doesn't mean that we want to eliminate everything, but maybe we want to repurpose everything. Because we find that this is a very good area. It's like it has the potential to become the face of Tokyo when you come from the bay. So, that's why we distribute in this way.
Yes. And I think the last place you draw some section, and the section is so unique. You put some volume covering the highway, and the structure itself is so difficult to stand now, but you can add some structure to support the volume. Touch the volume to the on the highway, but you should detach the volume to the highway. It should be detached.
Yeah.
Now you put on the highway, but it is difficult.
No. We agree completely with you. We know what is drawn there is impossible. It was just a way to say that if we just create green spaces around the highway in order to protect the noise and stuff, actually we find out that maybe building will protect better than in trees. We know we cannot use the structure of the highway to build what is shown there. We need to come with a different idea. We just want to show that maybe we should close the highway into architecture. It doesn't mean that we need to do it just in front of it. But yeah, you're right, it cannot hold us.
Yes. And also, you should ignore the regulation. Because in Tokyo area, you have to have a permission to build on the road. Building on the road is so difficult in Tokyo.
Okay.
But please ignore the regulation.
Okay, I'm very happy to ignore the regulation.
Probably the highway makes some air pollution. So, we should cover some shell. With shell, the road should be covered with some shell. Because the car makes some air pollution and the sound is so loud. You should cover the with some structure.
Oh, yeah. It doesn't actually, if we...
You can make some carved roof on the housing.
Yep. Well,
that is a function.
The point was exactly that, that we were finding that the road is a source of pollution and noise. And our major concern was how to avoid this. So we find out that maybe building around it, making the highway into a tunnel, would be a good way to do it. And just having a tunnel on the air, we thought it was going to be a bit simplistic. So we came with this crazy idea. But yeah, it needs very much further development. We forgot to mention that we find the highway not as an inconvenient but as an asset, not only because of the connectivity it's giving to us, but also because of the potentials of producing energy from the passing traffic. And in the previous presentation, I completely ignored, I forgot to mention all the sustainable issues we find here, because we want to create in the ground level more of a resilient area that gives a bit of a less static way of living, and creating also protection from the sometimes angry water. And this could originate like the water ecosystem with seaweeds and the repopulation of Tokyo Bay class. Because as the plan they are doing at the moment in New York, the repopulation of the oysters, I don't know if you're familiar with that one, but we found a bit of similarity, so we thought we could use it.
Yeah. You want to use the oysters?
No, in the Tokyo clam.
The Tokyo clam?
Okay. The Tokyo Bay clam.
Okay. I will talk to the New York professor, actually I know her. Or the oyster. It's called the Oyster Lady, it's a professor in Columbia University. Kate Dorff.
So yeah, we know that our major issue at the moment is how to deal with the highway, because we don't want to change its level because we need connection to the Rainbow Bridge. So it's a big issue for us at the moment.
Any further comments? Sometimes the plan, even the synthesis plan, even if it looks attractive, sometimes it seems that it's too much tabula rasa. And maybe we can find some balance between what it is already there and
take advantage of all the structures that already exist, maybe it would be a good point. Yeah, because the whole front almost disappeared in the drawing at the moment.
Yeah, we just kept the warehouses in
the hill on the way. Okay.
Yeah.
You have any further comments? We are actually.
Why don't you put two or three from our residential building in the main area? Because I worry a total floor area of this island will be reducing by this way, I think. And the path of weather in this area, maybe people can't see the scene, and not so much the scene thing, I think. How do you think about it?
That's the thing is, if we give the seafront to the residential areas, we are taking it away from the rest of the city. So we decide, I want to show you now the plan. As you can see, some of the blue areas having connection to the sea, some are not. In order to give some of the other areas as public facilities for the blue city.
And you want to make the small scale city like a village for the residential area, isn't it?
I think
not urbanized though, or for me, this section looks like a village or a
city. Yeah. We don't want to grow the residential area too high. We want more like a compact area with not too wide streets in order to create a lot of light spaces, giving cohesion to the proposal, but maybe not going on to vertical. We are leaving the vertical growing more for the what we call the 24-hour city.
No.
Well, what is
true? Okay.
Sorry, I didn't get that.
What's the business? Where is the building?
What?
Sí, sí.
Más, más.
No sé si.
Ima. Okay.
あ、これ全然、聞こえますよ。誰がこれに投資したいのかって聞いたんですけど。
I think the problem that is missing in the main plan is that they have two different concepts, but they have just one color to define the residential areas, and that makes it a little bit a little bit confusing to explain because they have different concepts for residential blue areas. But they have to develop that. Of course, it's just only around 3-4 weeks of work with a lot of problems, and actually they, for all the teams, it has been quite difficult to enter Tokyo Bay without any knowledge, just only all the documents, legal documents, planning, and the pictures that we were able to show to the students. But well, this is it. This is the three students already presented. We will have 1 hour. We will have 1 hour.